What's going on, moms and dads? My name is Dr. John Caruso. I am a pediatric, prenatal, family wellness chiropractor in Katy, Texas. And I want to share with you the five must-haves to look for when choosing a chiropractor for either yourselves, your family, or your kids. And so if you have seen our social media, or if you haven't, at Hayden Family Chiro on Instagram and on Facebook, if you've seen our website, if you've seen our reels, our posts, or you know, even if you've been inside of our office, then you know that we see a lot of kids at Hayden Family Chiropractic. And so in this video, I want to share with you exactly what makes our office pediatric focused, because it's not just our toys or the toy room, even though we do have some of the best toys ever created. It's not just our snacks, because those are both good and good for them. And it's not the fun that we have, because there's kids that are parkouring all over the office, especially in the evenings. But these five must-haves focus on what makes us entirely different from a traditional chiropractic office, and then allows us to get amazing results with some of the toughest of pediatric cases. Plus, you know, we know that you have friends and family who may live further away, out of Houston, out of Texas, that you may have recommended pediatric chiropractic care for. And so this video will help you, and it'll help them know exactly what to look for when choosing an office. And if you need help finding an office like ours, out of Houston, out of state, send us a DM, shoot us a message. We would be so happy to connect you with some of the best offices all around the state, all around the country. But let's just go straight into it with the five must-have things to look for in a pediatric chiropractor, so that way you guys know without a doubt that you are in the right place. The most common thing that I'll hear, especially from moms that are calling into the office, is like, you know, I had a really great experience with chiropractic. I just can't really track with how this could be helpful for my kid with colic, reflux, constipation, or anxiety, asthma, autism, seizures, etc. And so for that, we really have to dive deep into the level of training, and we'll talk about that in a second. The first point that I always share with parents is that when you're looking for a new provider, or a pediatric chiropractor for that matter, is that they need to have advanced pediatric education as well as training. And while we all know that no matter the industry, education is not everything in and of itself, but taking care of kids, and especially tough neurological cases like autism, like ADD, ADHD, anxiety, or seizures, or even chronic illnesses like PANS and PANDAS, they absolutely require additional and advanced training for a pediatric chiropractor. And that goes far beyond taking care of the spine, back pain, neck pain, headaches, migraines, sports injuries, and the things in standard chiropractic education. And so in order to really achieve clinical proficiency as a pediatric chiropractor, we should have at least an additional 80 to 100 hours of additional training. And we should be actively involved in ongoing advanced training today and forever forward. And then we also need to be the sort of doctor who's constantly looking to learn, improve, and find ways to get even better clinical results at all times. This is exactly how I've structured my office and choose to invest my time, my energy, my bandwidth in each and every single month on a consistent basis. I train with a network of hundreds of chiropractors through a couple of different avenues. So the Peak Potential Institute with Dr. Martin Rosen, the Focus Academy with Dr. Amy Spolstra, and then the Pediatric Experience, or PX Docs, platform. Now, these are the most advanced and focused training available for the profession right now for pediatric and family care. So those are the places that I would start. The ICPA and the CACCP certification is a phenomenal starting point. In some of the deeper stuff, especially when we start talking about neurologically complex cases or neurodevelopmental disorders, that's really where we need to shift our focus to more of the Focus Academy, to the Pediatric Experience, or PX Docs, as well as the Peak Potential Institute, to learn a lot of the really intensive type work. The second point that I always tell parents is that, you know, your provider needs to have a high level of clinical experience. And first off, this doesn't necessarily mean that your child's chiropractor needs to have been in practice for a certain number of years or is a certain age. And honestly, some of the top pediatric and family chiropractors in practice today, they're all young, but they've chosen to focus all of their advanced training and clinical experiences in things like internships and associates, and in high-level pediatric programs and offices to be able to cater to and focus in on some of these really complex and complicated is not the right word, but complex cases that we've talked about before. And, you know, many chiropractors awesomely have a huge heart when it comes to taking care of kids. And they might have even put the word family in the name of their practice, but day-to-day see very few kids and still end up with about 80 to 90% of their patients being adults with back pain and neck pain and migraines and headaches and spinal problems. And, you know, chiropractic is so wonderful for helping adults with those things, but it does mean that they likely just don't have enough reps to be able to take care of kids at the most advanced levels as a pediatric chiropractor. In my practice, I see about 80% kids. And of those 80% of kids in my practice, the vast majority of them have some type of neurodevelopmental disorder or complex neurological challenge like ADD, ADHD, anxiety, autism, or seizures. The vast majority of the kids in my practice are all under the age of 3 for the most part. I've got a bunch of teens and stuff in the office too, but the vast majority of the kids that I see within the office have these complex neurological issues. The other 20% or so are typically pregnant moms or expecting mothers or are postpartum with their babies. And there's a couple of dads and a couple of non-pregnant women also within the office as well. But those are some of the things that need to be put into place when we talk about clinical experience and reps, so to speak. The third, and probably one of the most important, is that the chiropractor or the office that you are looking for needs to be able to incorporate advanced neurological examinations, like the Insight scanning technology we use right here within the office. And so whenever I have patients coming in from other chiropractic office, the first question that I usually ask is, did your chiropractor use Insight scanning technology or any advanced neurological testing, or did they simply just rely on standard exams like posture and palpation? Now, while those things are really, really great, it doesn't allow us to get to the depth of the neurological complexity with things like autism, ADD, ADHD, seizures. Now, I cannot sing the praises of this advanced technology enough, and really, I don't feel like we should even be providing chiropractic care for simple cases like low back pain, headaches, and migraines without first measuring the patient's central and autonomic nervous system function with this amazing technology consisting of, you know, the neurothermal exam, surface electromyography, and then heart rate variability scans that are all a part of it. And so if you are looking to make functional and long-lasting changes to neurological function, it means two things. First, you have to get a baseline measurement to really know what you're dealing with, and then put together a customized and personalized neurological care plan and adjusting approach for that patient. We'll talk about that in the next two points. Secondly, you need to then utilize this technology to continually track and measure progress. The biggest thing is kids make a whole lot of change really fast. The brain grows the most in size in the first year, that makes the most connections within the first 3 years of life, and then brain waves shift all the way until about age 7. So there's a whole lot of neurological impact that happens from a developmental side with these kids. And if you're not able to stay dynamic with the process, well, then you're kind of just doing the same thing over and over. And so constantly having a checks and balances system of knowing what exactly to do, what not to do, and how to do it is crucial when you're trying to get really solid change and progress with a lot of these kids in these cases. And so when we ask parents who previously saw another family chiropractor and they didn't really see the results that they wanted, we asked if there was any continued progress evaluations or exams or scans or ways to really measure real neurological change and improvements that were happening. And the answer is always no, there wasn't. And so, you know, one thing to really watch for is if your child's adjustments are pretty much the same exact thing every single time on repeat. You know, if the pediatric chiropractor does not utilize scanning technology and a neurotonal approach to adjusting that we'll talk about next, this is almost always the case because, you know, doing the same thing every single time and expecting a result is kind of the definition of insanity. And so the real reason as to why we look at neurological scans is so that we can adjust the way or the approach that we take care of these kids, because as they make change and progress, we should also change our approach to stay dynamic with them so that way we can get the best results possible. Which then leads me into my fourth point. Babies and kids are not just little adults with little spines, and they need to be taken care of in that way. So being able to utilize a multitude of adjusting techniques, especially those that utilize a neurotonal approach, is key when taking care of a lot of these babies, but also a lot of these neurologically complex cases too. You know, this is getting super nerdy and it's getting granular with how chiropractic really works and gets some of the best results. And yet we can keep it super simple by saying what should be quite obvious. Every kid is different. Every case is different. Every diagnosis is different. You know, one of my big mentors talks about, you know, if you've seen or met one child with autism, you've only seen or met one child with autism, because every single child is different. The same thing with a latch and feeding case or a reflux case or any of these other things that we've talked about so far is that every single one is different. And not every kid gets the integrator, which is a type of adjusting tool that I'll use, or the toggle headpiece or cranial work for that matter. It's all case specific and it's all case dependent. And so having a large repertoire of adjusting techniques and approaches is what allows us to stay dynamic and get the best results with these kids. And so each child, like we talked about, has their own unique case history with different forms of birth trauma, toxins, illness, and emotional stress that's negatively affected the nervous system. And so if a pediatric chiropractor does not consider all of these different factors and then personalize and match the adjusting technique and approach that they use to meet those child-specific needs, then they really shouldn't expect to get positive clinical results in the vast majority of cases. This is one of my most important things, and one of the things that's at top priority for me is being trained and experienced in a vast majority of chiropractic techniques and adjusting approaches. And I don't just use my favorite or what I like to do. I always choose and start with one single rule in mind, and it's what is absolutely needed and necessary for that child to get the absolute best clinical results. This one really goes back to the first and the second one that we talked about, where, you know, if you don't have the right training, if you don't have the right education on a multitude of techniques and information, especially when we talk about neurodevelopmental disorders, then the experience and the clinical systems to know which one to use, you're really not going to get the same level of results as someone who does. And this is something that I see quite a bit within my practice. The fifth and final point is recommending a customized care plan, starting out with enough frequency and then recommending enough duration of care. And so this is one of those, it seems like a simple thing, where something can be so simple but can be so profound and have such a large impact. If the care plan for your kid or your child, which means like how often they were getting adjusted within a week and for how long, isn't enough, then simply put, there can be no expectations that the pediatric chiropractor can achieve solid clinical results. The care plan frequency and duration are so pivotal within our office and important that we follow a advanced scientific approach to care planning and utilize it with every single patient that comes into the office. And so if a general family chiropractor does not have advanced and updated care planning systems and recommends for your child to be seen like once or twice a week, or even worse, once or twice a month, then there's really no chance that they'd be able to get the real neurological change and results, given our understanding about how stressed out, overwhelmed, and locked in and subluxated kids are today. So if chiropractic hasn't necessarily worked in the past, it may be as simple as needing a customized, data-driven, and experience-driven care plan that follows the principles that we've talked about within this whole video. And so if you guys are right where that mom that we talked about earlier calling in was like, I'm just not tracking, I don't really understand, can you help me? I hope this video has helped you. And if you want to talk through this more and discuss specifics, we would love to be able to chat. I'm a parent myself, and our child gets adjusted regularly on a care plan, and I'd love to be able to share with you his experience and our experience as a parent, but also to connect you with some families within the office to really get an understanding of how chiropractic has not only impacted their child, but also impacted their family as well. And so to close this out, first, just please, please, please ask any questions. Leave us a comment below or shoot us a DM. Secondly, share this with other parents, family members, Facebook groups who need to hear this. And third, check out our website. We've got a ton of articles and blog posts. There's a lot of really, really great information on our website. Definitely check that out. And then if you need any help at all finding an office outside of Houston, outside of Texas, go ahead and